Hey guys, it's Jeff here with something a little bit different today. I recently had to repair my 2015 MacBook Pro, which had a battery swell issue and needed to be replaced. This won't be a repair tutorial, and instead I'll be sharing how this happened and why I'm repairing it myself. So having built my own PCs before, diagnosing and fixing computer issues aren't a big deal for me. By looking at some videos of how battery replacement is done, I assessed that this would be a relatively easy fix, just removing the back case, some cables, and getting the old battery out. Looked pretty straightforward. So a $40 replacement battery purchased on eBay and some time spent, I'll be able to get my laptop working again. So why am I still using this 8-plus-year-old laptop? Well, it still has pretty amazing specs. 2.8GHz quad-core i7, 16GB of RAM, and a 512GB SSD. Even though my screen is cracked, the speakers are busted, it has been a powerhouse as my main desktop computer. I'm choosing to do self-repair because it's the most affordable option and it's very normal for me to try and fix something I own. I grew up where money was tight in my family. If something broke, my dad would always make an attempt to fix it. This could be something in the car or in the house. He was just overall a very handy man and didn't like to spend money replacing items that were repairable and still usable. This ultimately shaped who I am today. So how did I find out my laptop needed repair? I've been using my laptop with the lid closed for several years because the screen was cracked. I noticed a bulge around the keyboard area of my laptop when I had to open the lid to use the trackpad. I didn't think much of it at first since the laptop seemed to be working fine, and I wasn't prepared to stop using it. I also didn't know how bad a battery swell could be, so I kept using my laptop as normal. It wasn't until one day I noticed an awful smell in my room. I didn't know where this smell was coming from, and I didn't think it could be my laptop at all. After cleaning my room thoroughly, the smell was still around. At some point, it finally clicked on me that it may be something to do with my laptop. I quickly googled what a battery swell might cause. A bulging battery meant that the battery was dying and producing a gas due to decomposing electrolytes. I finally had my answer to the awful smell. I also found out how unsafe it was to keep using the laptop, since it was a ticking time bomb, and smelling the off gas was a health hazard. At that point, I decided to stop and back up everything. I felt like I was putting myself in danger. I unplugged everything and removed the laptop from my room until I was ready to replace the battery. Part of the reason why I'm sharing this repair is to exercise my right to repair. I bought it and own it, and I should be able to do what I want with it. Consumers should have options, and self-repair should always be one. Not everyone can afford or has the time for a manufacturer repair. If I wanted Apple to replace the battery for me, it would have cost $249. But I actually can't even request that anymore because this laptop is too old and not even on their list of serviceable laptops. I suppose if it's not serviced by Apple anymore, then this laptop is done for, and I should just buy a new MacBook, right? Hell no. That's incredibly wasteful when it's still usable. So, my only option ends up being a self or independent repair to extend the life of my perfectly usable laptop. And manufacturers shouldn't create any barriers for that unless they're admittedly trying to be wasteful. I'll make the call when it's time for an upgrade. Now, time to wrap up this repair. The only real difficulty I had was the adhesive on the battery sticking to the case. With a little alcohol and a plastic card, I was able to get it off eventually. So, I actually did poke one part of the battery, causing it to deflate, but nothing happened. So, out with the old and in with the new. I successfully installed the new battery, plugged and screwed everything back in, and the battery is working and charging. That's all for today, and I hope you guys are exercising your right to repair.